Hey guys, welcome to MNMMPD NAATI YouTube channel. Today I will be continuing my series about NAATI Gujarati videos. So we have already posted one video wherein we have shared the introduction, overview, how does the exam look like, what are the advantages of giving the exam, and then like an in a nutshell video. Now today I want to discuss the note-taking strategies when you have already decided that let's give this NAATI Gujarati exam. The most important skill that you need to master when you want to give this NAATI Gujarati exam is your note-taking strategy, because if your note-taking is good, that's when that gives you a confidence to deliver the information correctly. But if your note-taking is not good, doesn't matter how good your vocabulary is, how good your command over the language is, but if you have not written the content, you cannot remember everything, and hence you will miss delivering the information, and that will reduce a lot of scores. So let us focus on note taking today. So I feel there should be a flow chart for every exam. You need to make a flow chart for yourself that this is the first thing I will do, this is the second thing I will do, and then the third and fourth. You should have a plan in picture. Just don't randomly start doing whatever you feel like, because that's not the real way of tackling the exam efficiently. The first thing I would focus on is vocabulary. Let's say you give 3, 4, 5 days to vocabulary. In few days, you should master vocabulary, whatever you feel is important for this exam. Maximum 5 days, I feel, is enough, because I have prepared a few pages of vocabulary. If you do them, that's more than enough. You don't need to do anything more. So let's say you take 3, 4 days or 5 days maximum to finish that vocabulary. After that, the next thing you should start is building your skills for note taking. Not delivering the information. First, at least 1 to 2 days, you should focus only on taking notes. Are you able to take notes? Are you able to write down every single point? Now, when I say every single point, it doesn't mean you all know that there are two dialogues, okay? Now, let's say dialogue one. It may have anything between 12 to 14 segments. Now, what do you mean by segments? Let's say, first of all, whenever a dialogue begins, what is the first thing that happens? They will give you a scenario. For example, this is a dialogue between a teacher and a student. A student has gone to a teacher with some questions regarding studies. The teacher speaks in English and the student talks in Gujarati. The dialogue begins now. So first thing they will do is they will give you this scenario. Now, when they are giving you this scenario, what is your job? Because you don't have to, you know, speak the opposite language of this scenario. And so you should not sit quietly and do nothing and just listen. That is not something that you should do. What you should do is, first thing, when they are giving you that scenario, that background information, start your, you know, imagination process. What did they say? A teacher, a student, all right? Now, just visualize a scene in front of you. Like there is a teacher sitting, there is a table, there's a chair, there's a teacher sitting, a student comes in and then starts asking questions. Why is this important? When you get into that zone, when your brain gets into that zone of imagination of that scene, what happens is it's easy for you to come up with the words related to teacher, students, assignments, studies, and whatnot. Now your brain knows what to speak, what to imagine, what to visualize. This is very important. This power of imagination is impeccable, I would say, and it plays a major role. At least it has done a huge advantage for me, I would say. So that's the first thing I would do. Second, if there are names, let's say, for example, teacher is Rahul and the student is Yash, for example, start making the short forms in your notebook that you have. So now you know teacher is Rahul. So I would just write down TCHR is Rahul, AR, and student, STU, student is Yash. Why? Why will I do this? Because so many times you will see the names are getting repeated. You cannot write Rahul, R-A-H-U-L, Yash, Y-A-S-H every time. You don't have that kind of time. You have to train your brain from the get-go, from the first second, that R is Rahul and Y is Yash. so that you can save those few seconds in doing something else that will be a productive use of your time. So that's the first thing I would do. Second, now that I know what's the scenario about, I am pretty aware that, okay, I will get something related to homework, assignments, and whatnot, all right? So obviously, then they will start, you know, speaking the dialogue. So the first thing is, let's say, "Hi Yash, good to see you this morning. How can I help you?" Let's say the teacher has started talking, all right? Now, I have to obviously take notes, because sometimes you may feel, oh, this is such a small segment. This is a very easy segment. I don't need to take notes. That's fine. You will get difficult segments as well. You will get long segments as well. You will not always get what you want. So it's good to have a habit of taking notes for the smallest of segments and obviously for the longest of the segments as well. All right. So I would always take notes. I would never underestimate thinking such a small segment, don't need to take notes. No, I would always take notes, because let's say the teacher says, "How can I help you today?" And you say, hun aaje tamari kai rite madad karu. And that aaje, because the teacher said today, and you say, hun tamari kai rite madad karu. You should have said, hun tamari aaje kai rite madad karu. That aaje, one word, today. If you miss such a small word, you missed, that will be a contribution towards reducing your score. Because you haven't taken notes, you might say, hun tamari kai rite madad karu. No, hun tamari aaje kai rite madad karu. How can I help you today? For example, a lot of times I have seen students doing this. Thank you very, very much. Such an easy word. Tamaro khub khub abhar. If you say tamaro abhar, thank you very much. Tamaro khub khub abhar, very, very much. All right. That very khub khub is very important. These small little places, you lose your scores. Not for the big, you know, segments. You will deliver information. But sometimes when you underestimate a segment, thinking it is a very small one and I do not need to take notes, that's when the beginning of wrong things will happen, I would suggest. I feel that way. All right. So the first segment, let's say the teacher says, "Hi Yash, it's good to see you today here. How can I help you?" Okay, that's my segment. So how will I take notes? Like this. Let's say, "Hi Yash, it's good to see you today here. How can I help you?" Now, how have I taken notes? From the first day, start making short forms for yourself, because a lot of segments, a lot of words, a lot of sentences you will see getting repeated. Like, for example, "Thank you very, very much. How can I help you? How can I help you today? My name is so and so," and whatnot. "Good evening, good morning," and all these things. Start making short forms, write it down at the side of your notebook, so that when you listen to such words, you don't write the entire sentence or the word. You write down only the short form. When you practice 30, 40, 50 dialogues and go in the exam with the same shortcuts, your brain exactly knows what that shortcut is. Or if you get that segment or a sentence in exam, what are you supposed to do when you take notes? For example, what have I done here? "Hi, Yash. I have not written the entire name." Now my brain knows what is why, because I took that pain of writing why when the speaker was giving the introduction. "Good GD to see you today." Now this too, I could have written like this as well, too. That also saves time. "Good to see you today." Now my brain knows this is good. This is to see you today here. Okay. "How can I help?" Such a big sentence. No need to write HLP help and a question mark. Whenever they speak any sentence in the form of a question, I will make sure I have put a question mark so that my brain knows while delivering the opposite language, this is a question, not a sentence. So I will always put a question mark if it is a question. Now, do you see how have I taken notes? I cannot write like this when the speaker is saying, "Hi, Yash, good to see you today." Can you imagine if you write like this, every word in its complete form, in a very good handwriting, Can you imagine? Can you finish taking notes? Never. You will not even finish taking the easiest segment, forget the difficult ones. So if you don't practice every single day, 2, 3, 4, 5 dialogues, the note taking of the dialogues, the short forms, you will never be able to build up that level wherein in exam you actually don't need to write the full segment. You just write the short forms and there you are. For example, if you have done PT, how do you take notes in write from dictation? It is a sentence, right? It's a long sentence. You never write down the entire sentence. You write down either the initials or the short form. It still helps you. Similar logic. Here, you cannot go for initials. That's very hard. It's understandable that initials will not make sense. Sometimes, not always. But the better way is to write down the short form. Now, how do I deliver the information? Hi, Yash. તમને આજે અહીંયા જોઈને સારું લાગ્યું, હું તમારી કઈ રીતે મદદ કરી શકું છું? આઈ જસ્ટ સિમ્પલી ડિલિવર્ડ ઇન ગુજરાતી. હાઉ કુડ આઈ ડૂ દેટ? બિકોઝ આઈ કેન અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડ માય નોટ્સ. આઈ નો વોટ એવરી સિંગલ શોર્ટ ફોર્મ મીન્સ. આઈ કેન ક્લિયરલી રીડ ઇટ. દેટ્સ વાય ધ ડિલિવરી ઓફ ગુજરાતી લેંગ્વેજ વોઝ ફ્લુએન્ટ, ક્લિયર, વિદાઉટ એની હેઝિટેશન, વિદાઉટ એની રિપીટેશન એન્ડ વિદાઉટ એની મિસ્ટેક્સ. યસ, આઈ નો દિસ ઇઝ એન ઇઝી સેગમેન્ટ, ઇટ્સ નોટ હાર્ડ, બટ ઇટ ઓલવેઝ સ્ટાર્ટ્સ ફ્રોમ સમવેર. યુ હેવ ટુ સ્ટાર્ટ ફ્રોમ ઇઝી સેગમેન્ટ્સ એન્ડ દેન યુ હેવ ટુ ગો ટુ ધ હાયર વન્સ. ઓબ્વિયસલી વી વિલ ડુ ડાયલોગ્સ એન્ડ ઓલ દેટ. ટુડે આઈ જસ્ટ વોન્ટ ટુ ગીવ યુ એન ઓવરવ્યૂ ઓફ હાઉ ટુ બિલ્ડ યોર નોટ ટેકિંગ સ્કિલ્સ. ઓલરાઇટ, સો ઓબ્વિયસલી આઈ વિલ સ્ટાર્ટ ફ્રોમ ઇઝી level and then eventually in the future videos we will go to that level which will not be very easy. All right, now you understand what I'm trying to say. First things first, understand the dialogue, the introduction, short form, start making them, note taking, write the notes in short form. You cannot write every single word. Also, when you take notes, you have to do two things at the same time. You are taking notes, that's perfectly fine. Also, when you listen to the dialogue, start imagining what's happening. What is the speaker saying? If you imagine, if you literally visualize what they are saying, it becomes very easy for you to remember and to deliver the information. As I have already told in other videos of NAATI Hindi, the same logic applies for NAATI Gujarati. And what is that? We are not here to do word by word translation. We are here to deliver the information. So if the word changes here and there, that's fine. The meaning should not change. Whatever they are speaking in English, if you are able to deliver the same information with the same meaning in Gujarati, you will get a good score. Similarly, vice versa. If they said something in Gujarati and you are able to deliver the same meaning, the same information without adding anything, without subtracting anything, and without, you know, messing up with the meaning, you will get your score. Understand one thing, deliver the correct meaning. Never change the meaning. If you change the meaning of the segment, that's when you lose your score. Second thing is, start memorizing the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 till 100. You should know how to call that number in Gujarati. All right. For example, 84. I should know that 84 એટલે 84. બરાબર, હવે મને ના આવડતું હોય તો પછી જ્યારે એ 84 બોલશે કે ભાઈ વોટ ઇઝ યોર એડ્રેસ, 84/A રિચફિલ્ડ એવન્યુ ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ, તમે શું બોલશો? 84/A રિચફિલ્ડ એવન્યુ? નો, 84/A રિચફિલ્ડ એવન્યુ. જ્યાં બનતું હોય ત્યાં ગુજરાતી કરવું જ પડશે. સ્લેશ એનું ગુજરાતી નહીં કરવાનું, રિચફિલ્ડ એવન્યુનું ગુજરાતી નથી કરવાનું. નામનું ગુજરાતી ના થઈ શકે. જ્હોન છે તો ગુજરાતીમાં બી જ્હોન જ્હોન જ રહેશે. જ્હોન જનક ના થઈ શકે ગુજરાતીમાં. ઓકે, નેમ ડઝન્ટ ચેન્જ. વોટ વી કેન ચેન્જ, વી વિલ ચેન્જ દેટ પાર્ટ ઓનલી. એટલે જ્યાં બનતું હોય ત્યાં ચેન્જીસ કરીએ તો સારું, સો દેટ વી અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડ દેટ વી કેન, યુ નો, ગેઇન મેક્સિમમ માર્ક્સ. અને જ્યાં લાગતું હોય કે ભાઈ આ તો નામ છે, આ તો પોસ્ટનું નામ છે, સીઈઓ, ઓલરાઇટ, ક્લર્ક, ત્યાં કરવાની જરૂર નથી. બરાબર, પણ જ્યાં લાગતું હોય ના આની ગુજરાતી થાય, ત્યાં કરવી જોઈએ મારા હિસાબે. સો આઈ હોપ મેં તમને એક જ સેગમેન્ટ કરીને બતાવ્યું. આઈ નો મેં કે તમને બહુ ડિટેલ્ડ નોટ ટેકિંગ આજે નથી બતાવી, બટ મારે તમને એક ઓવરવ્યૂ આપવું હતું કે નોટ ટેકિંગ વખતે કઈ વસ્તુઓ ધ્યાનમાં રાખવી, નોટ્સ કઈ રીતે લેવાની, અને સાથે સાથે જે આ પાવર ઓફ ઇમેજિનેશન છે, યુ હેવ ટુ બી પેરેલલ, યુ હેવ ટુ વિઝ્યુઅલાઇઝ વોટ્સ ગોઈંગ ઓન, યુ હેવ ટુ બી અ પાર્ટ ઓફ ધ સ્ટોરી. યુ નો, ઇમેજિન કરો કે તમે ત્યાં ઊભા છો અને તમારી સામે એક ટીચર અને સ્ટુડન્ટ વાત કરે છે, અને પછી જુઓ તમે જ્યારે સ્ટોરીમાં ઇન્વોલ્વ થઈ જશો તો તમને કઈ રીતે ઇટ બિકમ્સ વેરી ઇઝી ટુ રિમેમ્બર. જો તમે કદાચ ઇફ યુ હેવ વોચ્ડ ધ મૂવી દૃશ્યમ, વોટ ઇઝ ધ ડાયલોગ ઓવર દેર ઇન દેટ મૂવી, દેટ વિઝ્યુઅલ મેમરીઝ આર વેરી સ્ટ્રોંગ. ઓલરાઇટ, ઇફ યુ વિઝ્યુઅલાઇઝ સમથિંગ, it stays in your memory for a long, long time. So when you watch these movies, let's learn something from them as well. And I technically learned this trick from that movie. And that's how I understood that if I imagine something, if I visualize something, I can keep it in my memory for that few, for those few minutes or seconds. Because after every dialogue, there is a beep sound. After the beep sound, you start speaking after 2-3 seconds of the beep sound. So let's say beep sound, 2-3 seconds gap, and then you start speaking. So you have a few seconds to complete your segment, whatever you want to complete. But then when you start speaking, how can you be fluent? You paid attention to what the speaker was saying, and obviously you have practiced enough. You have taken good notes and you can speak. In Nati Gujarati, અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડ વન થિંગ, તમે રોજ પ્રેક્ટિસ નહીં કરો તો તમને નહીં મજા આવે એક્ઝામમાં. તમે આજે મારી જોબ નથી, હું 4 કલાક બેસીને પ્રેક્ટિસ કરી લઉં, અને પછી 4 દિવસ જોબ છે, ઘરે આવીને થાકી ગયા, ભણ્યા નહીં, એવું નહીં ચાલે. ગુજરાતી નાટી એક્ઝામમાં એવું નહીં ચાલે. ફગેટ ગુજરાતી નાટી, કોઈ એક્ઝામમાં એવું ના ચાલે, પણ હું તમને સ્પેસિફિકલી અહીંયા કહું છું, પ્લીઝ પ્રેક્ટિસ એવરી સિંગલ ડે. વોકેબ્લરી રિવાઇઝ કરો, કંઈ કામ કરતા હોય, ટ્રાવેલ કરતા હોય, ઓબ્વિયસલી નોટ વાઇલ ડ્રાઇવિંગ, બટ કંઈ કામ કરતા હોય અને તમને એવું લાગતું હોય કે ના હું ફ્રી છું, વોકેબ્લરી રિવાઇઝ કરો એવરી ડે. એઝ યુ નો, બિફોર ગોઈંગ ટુ બેડ ક્વિકલી ફટાફટ વોકેબ્લરી રિવાઇઝ કરી લીધી. એક ડાયલોગ બને તો એક ડાયલોગ, સવારે બે ડાયલોગ, સાંજે એક ડાયલોગ, એવરી ડે પ્રેક્ટિસ કરો, ત્યારે સ્કિલ્સ બિલ્ડઅપ થશે. આજે કરીને 4 દિવસ નહીં કરો, 5મા દિવસે જ્યાં હતા ત્યાંના ત્યાં ઝીરોથી જ સ્ટાર્ટ કરશો. ઓકે, સો and after all this, if you feel you need further consultations and all that, you should know that we are there for you. Text karo messenger par jaine, or Instagram is there, go and text there. You know, get in touch with us, we'll see if we can book some one-on-one consultations for you, or if you want further, you know, assistance, we can see what pathway we can go for you, because every student is different. Every student's requirement is different. We will listen to your side of the story first, and then we'll figure out what's the best possible solution for you. Very, very soon, I'm coming up with the prediction file. It's almost ready, I would say. I'm there 70%, but haju thoda dialogues hu record karu chu. Pati jaise, pachi will start sharing. Practice hard. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. With that, I'll take your leave. Bye for now.